Good morning, students. Now we are going to discuss about some basic terms involved in the superposition of light waves. What are those basic terms involved in the superposition of light waves? Superposition means the overlapping of one light wave over the another light wave, that is called superposition. Okay, so what are those terms? First term is phase. So let us discuss what you mean by phase. Phase is nothing but it is the state of vibration of the particle, or it is the location of vibration of the particle of the medium. Due to the vibration of the particle of the medium, the wave is propagating. So already we discussed about in case of the generation of water waves on the surface of calm water. Now let us consider it is a light wave. The light wave is propagating in which direction? The light wave is propagating in forward direction. Okay, so let us define the phase now. Phase of a wave at a point is the angle corresponding at that point. Here, angle gives the location of the oscillating particle or vibrating particle of the medium. Now, let us consider it is a source of light. Now, source of light can be represented by S here. So, suppose to be, I will take the point here now. This point can be taken as O. So, at the O, what is the angle here? Angle is 0 degree because it is a sine wave. Okay. So, if angle is 0 degree now, the sine value is also 0 degree. Means, the displacement of the particle is also 0 degree. Because already we know that. What is that? Y is equal to A into sine omega t. So, at the origin, the angle is 0. Angle is 0 means sine 0 is 0. Then the displacement is also 0 degree. Okay. So, what is the phase value at the point O? Phase value at the point O is 0 degree. Phase value at the point O is 0 degree. Suppose to be, I will take point P now. Okay. So, what is the angle corresponding at this point here? Angle corresponding at this point is 90 degree. Means the phase at the P is how much? 90 degree. In a full wave, what is the total angle? In the full wave, the total angle is 360 degree. Means, a full wave is generated in one oscillation. In one oscillation, the total angle covered is how much? 360 degree. Then I will take the point here. This is a point Q now. Then at the point Q, what is the angle here? 180 degree. Means the phase at the point Q. Means the angle corresponding for the point Q is how much? 180 degree. Here 180 degree is the point phase at the point Q now. Then let us take it is a P dash. So, what is the phase corresponding at this point P dash here? That is a 270 degree. Then I will take this as a point Q dash. So, what is the phase corresponding at the point Q dash here? That is a 360 degree. Then once again listen here. What do you mean by phase here? Phase of a wave at a point. At any point. So, at a point is the angle corresponding at that point. Means the angle corresponding for that point. What is the angle corresponding for the point O here? That is a 0 degree. Here phase is 0 degree. Then what is the angle corresponding for the point P here? That is a 90 degree. Means here phase is 90 degree. Okay. Then what is the angle corresponding for the point Q in the diagram? That is a 180 degree. So, what it is showing here, what it is telling here, it is nothing but it is angle corresponding for the point here. Okay, that is called phase. Okay, then next we are going to discuss about phase difference. Suppose to be two light waves are propagating in same direction and in the same medium. So let us consider it is a first wave. Here the waves are originating from source of light. It is a first wave. And the wave originating from the origin means the source of light, I'll take it as a second wave. Here both light waves having same wavelength, I will take it as a first wave and it is a second wave. First wave and it is a second wave. See here, it is a first wave and it is a second wave. So both waves having the same wavelength and same frequency. Okay, already we know that what do you mean by wavelength. Wavelength is nothing but it is the distance between one pole crest and one pole trough. Here, see here, it is for the first wave, and for the second wave the wavelength is again same here, because the distance between one pole crest and one pole trough is called wavelength. If wavelength is same, then frequency is same, then such waves are called coherent waves. Such waves are called coherent waves. See here. Then, what is the phase difference between these two waves? So, what is phase difference here? The difference in phases of waves. The difference in phases of waves at a point. At a point is known as phase difference. Is known as phase difference. So what is phase difference here? The difference in phases of waves. How many waves are there? Two waves are there. Waves meeting at a point. Where these two waves are meet here? These two waves are meet at the point O. And these two waves are meet at the point P, and these two waves are meet at the point Q. Meeting means here one wave, crest of one wave falls on the crest of another wave. Means crest of first wave falls on the crest of second wave here. Here also same. The crest of trough of first wave falls on the trough of second wave here. Means what is the phase difference here? Phase difference is nothing but at the point O, what is the phase for the first wave? That is 0 degree. Phase difference can be represented by pi. Then pi is equal to pi 1 minus of pi 2. Then what is pi 1? Pi 1 is nothing but it is the phase of the first wave, and pi 2 is nothing but phase of the second wave here. So now let us, we are going to write what about pi 1 here. Pi 1 is nothing but phase of the first wave at the O. So what is the phase of the first wave at the O? That is a 0 degree. Then it is a 0 degree. Then what is the phase of the second wave at the O? Again that is a 0 degree. Then 0 degree minus 0 degree, it is a 0 degree. Means phase difference between both waves is 0 degree. If phase difference between two waves is 0 degree, then there is a constructive interference. Let us discuss about what you mean by constructive interference and destructive interference in next topic. Okay, so see here, in constructive interference what happens? Crest of the one wave falls on the crest of the another wave, or the trough of the one wave falls on the trough of the another wave. Means crest on crest or trough on trough is called constructive interference. Here the resultant displacement becomes maximum, because we know that by the superposition principle y is equal to y1 plus y2. We are going to add them. Why we are going to add them here? So y1 is in positive direction, y2 is also is in positive direction. We are going to add them. We will get the resultant displacement of the resultant wave. It is a resultant wave of the both waves. It is a resultant wave because its displacement becomes maximum compared to the displacements of the both waves here. That is y is equal to y1 plus y2. If crest falls on crest, trough falls on trough, we are going to add the displacements. Okay. So this is about phase difference now. What is the phase difference at the point P now? phase difference for the first wave, that is a 90 degree. Phase difference for the second wave, that is also 90 degree. There at the point P, now 90 degree minus of 90 degree, again it is a 0 degree. So if phase difference is 0 degree, means the crest of first wave falls on the crest of second wave, or the trough of first wave falls on the trough of second wave. Okay, supposed to be in a previous case we discussed that two waves are meet in phase, but now we are going to discuss about two waves are meet out of phase. So if two waves are meet out of phase now, then what happens? We will discuss about that one. Supposed to be there are two light waves. Both light waves are propagating in same medium and in the same direction. And I will take it is a first light wave and it is a second light wave. Then both waves having the same wavelength and same frequency. Both waves having the same wavelength and same frequency. Okay, so these waves are called coherent waves here. See, what is the phase difference between them? I take it is the S1 and it is the S2. S1 means the first wave is originating from S1 and the second wave is originating from S2 here. Then what is the phase difference between them? So, phase of the first wave at the S1 is 0 degree. Because at the origin angle is 0 degree. Then, the phase of the second wave at the point S2 is 180 degree, because it is 0 degree, it is a 90 degree and it is a 180 degree. Then the difference in 180 degree and 0 degree, that gives the 180 degree. The phase difference between both light waves is how much? That is a 180 degree. If the phase difference between two light waves is 180 degree, then the displacements get subtracted here. So here y is equal to, I will write here, it is a y1, displacement of the first wave, because it is a first wave now. It is a displacement of the first wave. Displacement of the oscillating particle of the first wave, that is I will take y1, okay, at any instant, that is y1. And the displacement of the second wave at the same instant, that is y2. Then subtracting them, we will get the resultant wave, displacement of the resultant wave. So it is the displacement of the resultant wave. This dotted wave is nothing but resultant wave, because the displacement of resultant wave is decreased, because they get subtracted, because crest falls on trough and also trough falls on crest here. That is y is equal to y1 minus of y2. So what it is telling now, it is telling that if two light waves are meeting out of phase, the displacements get subtracted. If two light waves meeting out of phase, what do you mean by meeting out of phase here? Means the crest of one wave falls on the trough of another wave. Crest of one wave falls on the trough of another wave. So it tells that both waves are meeting out of phase. At which point the waves are meeting here? The waves are meeting at this point now. First wave and second wave both are meeting at this point now. But what is the phase difference between them? That is a 180 degree. Because the second wave is at 180 degree, but the first wave is at 0 degree. Hence, the phase difference between them is how much? 180 degree. If the phase difference between them is 180 degree, then they are meeting out of phase. If two light waves are meeting out of phase, so remember here, what do you mean by out of phase? Crest of one wave falls on the trough of another wave, or vice versa. So trough of one wave falls on the crest of another wave. Okay. If two light waves meeting out of phase, their displacements, their displacements get subtracted. Their displacements get subtracted. If two light waves are meeting in phase, okay, in phase, then their displacements get added. But here, the two light waves are meeting out of phase means their displacements get subtracted. Then the resultant displacement of the resultant wave can be written as y1 minus of y2 means the displacement of the first wave minus of displacement of the second wave. Already we know that what do you mean by displacement here? Displacement is nothing but it is a displacement of oscillating particle of the first wave and also second wave. Next we are going to discuss about path difference. What do you mean by path difference? Phase difference can be represented by pi, but path difference can be represented by delta x. So path difference is represented by delta x here. What do you mean by path difference? So it is the difference in path lengths of both waves meeting at a point here. Okay, what is the path difference here? The difference in path lengths of light waves meeting at a point is known as path difference. Okay. So now see here. So what about path difference from this diagram here? Here it is the path length of the first wave from 0 degree to that is 360 degree, that is lambda. Then what is the path difference of the second wave from 180 degree to 360 degree, that is lambda by 2. So once again listen here, what is the path length of first wave from 0 degree to 360 degree, that is lambda, because it is a full wave. Then what is the length of the full wave, that is called wavelength. Okay, then what is the path length of the second wave from 180 degree to 360 degree, that is lambda by 2. Then take the difference of them, you will get the path difference. Then path difference is nothing but here delta x is equal to lambda minus lambda by 2. What is lambda minus lambda by 2? Take 2 as LCM, it is a 2 lambda minus of lambda, then it is a lambda by 2. Then path difference between these two light waves which are meeting at a point now, that is a lambda by 2. See here, also same thing here. What is the path difference here? Both waves are meeting at this point now. This is the first wave and this is the second wave. Both waves are meeting at this point. So what is the path difference between these two light waves? Again it is a lambda by 2, because half of the wavelength, here for the one crest, its path length is how much? Half of the wavelength. Okay, so it is a lambda by 2. So if the phase difference is 180 degree, then the path difference is how much? Lambda by 2. Then here the waves are meeting out of phase. Okay. So next we are going to take the displacements. Displacement of the first wave and displacement of the second wave. Displacement of the first wave can be written as y1 is equal to, first wave is originating from where? That is originating from origin. That is a1 into sine omega t. Sine omega t here. Then what about the second wave? The displacement of second wave, that is y2 is equal to a2 into sine omega t plus pi. Because there is a phase difference between first wave and also second wave. See, it is a first wave and it is a second wave. then what is the phase difference between both waves? Phase difference between both waves I will take pi. It is a pi. Okay. So now we are going to write the y1, the displacement of the first wave. Means the displacement of the oscillating particle in first wave, that is y1 is equal to a1 into sine omega t, because here phase can be taken as 0 because it is originating from 0 now, means 0 degree. But here for the second wave, we are going to write the displacement formula as y2 is equal to a2 into sine omega t plus pi, because it is originating from 180 degree now. Instead of 180 degree, I will take pi here. Okay. So suppose to be, then what is the phase difference between y1 and y2 here? The phase difference between y1 and y2 means that is a pi. Means phase difference between two waves is pi here. Suppose, again I will take two light waves. It is a first light wave. And it is a second light wave. Then what is the phase difference between them? It is 90 degree now. It is 0 degree. So first wave is from 0 degree, but the second wave is from 90 degree. 90 minus of 0, that is a 90 degree. In general, I will take this phase difference as pi. Then what about path difference here? So path difference is nothing but that is a lambda by 4. Because, see here, in case of a full wave, the distance between one full crest and one full trough is called wavelength. Then, the path length of the full crest, that is lambda by 2. And the path length of the trough, full trough is again it is a lambda by 2. Then lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2, that gives the lambda, that is the wavelength of the full wave. Okay. Then now, suppose to be we are going to take 1 fourth of the full wave. So 1 fourth of the full wave means here path length is lambda by 4. Here also path length is lambda by 4. Then lambda by 4 plus lambda by 4, that is a lambda by 2. See here. Lambda by 4 plus lambda by 4. It is the path length of the crest. Okay. Lambda by 4 plus lambda by 4. Then what is common here? 1 by 4 is the common. And lambda is also common. So lambda by 4. Then it is a 1 plus 1. Then it is 2. Then 2 by 4. That is a 1 by 2. That is a lambda by 2. Okay. So next topic is that is very important topic, interference of light. Here interference of light is due to the superposition of light waves. Okay. Interference of light. Then now let us define what you mean by interference of light. So let us consider there are two sources of light. Both sources of light can emit the light waves of same frequency and same wavelength. Means both are coherent sources. So at the point P now, the both waves originating from the coherent sources will be overlapped. Then the light wave from the first source and the light wave from the second source. The light wave from the second source. And both light waves having the same frequency and same wavelength here. Then I will take it is the source of light S1 and it is the source of light S2. And here S1 and S2 are the coherent sources. And these two waves will be meet at the point P here. But these two waves will be meet out of phase. Because see here. The crest falls on trough. And the trough falls on crest. So if the crest falls on trough or trough falls on crest now. The waves will be meet at this point in out of phase here. out of phase means phase difference is 180 degree or anything. Okay. So, but we are going to discuss about phase difference in case of constructive interference and destructive interference in next topic. Okay. Then, this is the direction of first light wave and it is the direction of second light wave. Then, what is the path difference here? Path difference is lambda by 2. And what about phase difference? That is 180. Because it is 0 degree and it is 180 degree. Then 180 degree minus of 0 degree, that is of 180 degree. Then phase difference is 180 degree. In terms of radian, that is a pi. Pi radian. Okay, 180 degree in terms of radian, that is a pi radian. What about path difference here? Path difference is lambda by 2. That is half of the wavelength. Okay, see here. Phase difference is I will take pi and path difference I will take delta x. Delta x here. It is a path difference. Okay. Then what do you mean by interference of light? So whenever these two light waves are overlapped at the point P, you know, there is a superposition of light waves takes place at the point P. Then there is an interference of light will be takes place. Whenever both light waves are overlapped on each other now, there is a variation in intensity of the light. Okay. So that variation in intensity of the light due to the superposition of two or more light waves at the point of observation is called interference of light. Then what do you mean by interference of light? The variation in or the change in the variation in intensity in the region of superposition of in the region of superposition of superposition of two or more light waves of same frequency with constant phase difference means the phase difference does not change with time here with constant phase difference is called interference of light Then, on what factor the intensity of the light wave depends here? The intensity of the light wave depends on the amplitude. And intensity of the light wave is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude of the light wave. That is, I is directly proportional to amplitude square. I is directly proportional to amplitude square. Okay. So, if a crust falls on trough now, then what happens here? We are going to subtract the displacements here. If we are going to subtract the displacements, we are going to subtract the amplitudes. When we are going to subtract the amplitudes, there is a intensity of the light wave becomes minimum. Means there is a variation in intensity of the light wave due to the superposition of two or more light waves of same frequency. Same frequency means both light waves are coherent waves. With a constant phase difference means phase difference does not change with the time here. Okay. So this is about interference of light. Then there are two types of interference of light. So depending on phase difference and path difference, what are those types? Constructive interference and destructive interference. Now let us discuss one by one. Types of interference of light. Types of interference of light. So, what are the types of interference of light? So, The interference of light was proposed by Sir Isaac Newton, but experimentally proved by Thomas Young. Okay. Then there are how many types of interference of light? Two types of interference of light. What are those? First one is constructive interference and the second one is destructive interference. Now first we are going to discuss about constructive interference. Constructive interference. Then what do you mean by constructive interference? So when crest of one wave falls on or overlapped on crest of another wave or trough of one wave falls on trough of another wave. So, what is constructive interference here? When crest of one wave falls on crest of another wave, or trough of one wave falls on trough of another wave, then their displacements get added. Displacements get added means amplitudes get added. So this type of interference of light is called constructive interference, because intensity of the light waves become maximum after one light wave overlapped on another light wave. How the light waves are overlapped here? Crest of one wave falls on the crest of another wave, or the trough of one wave falls on the trough of another wave. What it's meaning here, the light waves are meet in phase means here the phase difference between them is 0, 360 degree or 720 degree, whatever. So we are going to discuss about conditions for constructive interference after the theory of interference of light. Okay, then this interference is called constructive interference. Then in constructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes maximum. Remember this one. In constructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes maximum when the one light wave overlapped on another light wave. How the light waves are overlapped here? Crest falls on crest and trough falls on troughs here. This is a first light wave and it is a second light wave. It is first one, it is second one. The resultant wave is this one. Then here amplitude is increased. Amplitude increased means intensity becomes maximum. Amplitude of the first wave, that is A1, and amplitude of the second wave, that is A2, and both are get added here. Then A1 plus A2, then the resultant amplitude of the resultant wave, that is R, is equal to A1 plus A2. Then how to find the intensity here? Intensity is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude of the resultant wave. That is, I is directly proportional to R square. Then intensity becomes maximum. In the constructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes maximum. Remember this one. In constructive interference, the intensity becomes maximum after superposition. Then next, what do you mean by destructive interference? So destructive interference is opposite to the constructive interference. In constructive interference, the waves are meet in phase. But in destructive interference, the waves are meet out of phase. Out of phase means here the phase difference is 180 degree. Okay. So we will discuss about the phase difference and path difference in case of constructive interference and destructive interference after the theory of interference of light. Then second type of interference of light. What is second type of interference of light? Second type, that is a destructive interference. In case of destructive interference, the resultant amplitude of resultant wave becomes minimum because the amplitudes get subtracted here, because crest of one wave falls on trough of another wave and vice versa. Okay, so what is a destructive interference? When crest of one wave falls on trough of another wave, means second wave, trough of another wave. Or vice versa. Vice versa means here, trough of one wave falls on the crest of another wave. Okay. Or vice versa. Then their displacements means the displacements of the both light waves. Then their displacements get subtracted. Means amplitudes get subtracted. This type of interference is called destructive interference. This interference is called destructive interference. Then in the destructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes minimum because crest falls on trough or trough falls on crest. Then what happens? The displacements get subtracted. As the displacements get subtracted, amplitudes get subtracted, then amplitude of the resultant wave is reduced. If amplitude of the resultant wave is reduced, then intensity of the resultant wave is also reduced. Then intensity becomes minimum. In destructive interference, I will write it is a DI. DI is nothing but here destructive interference. CI is nothing but constructive interference. The intensity becomes minimum, and even it becomes zero when both waves having same amplitude. The intensity becomes minimum. Now, what about destructive interference? See here. If two light waves meet out of phase, then meet out of phase means here crest falls on trough here or trough falls on crest here, then the displacements get subtracted, means amplitudes get subtracted, then intensity reduced because the resultant amplitude is reduced. Okay, then intensity of the light becomes minimum. Let us consider there are two light waves, they are meeting out of phase. It is a first wave, and both waves are propagating in same medium and same direction. Then it is a second wave. But both waves having the same wavelength and same frequency, but comparatively first wave, second wave having the minimum amplitude. I will take amplitude of the first wave as A1, but amplitude of the second wave as A2. Okay, so see here, it is an amplitude of first wave, that is A1, and amplitude of second wave is, that is A2. They are in opposite direction, but crest falls on trough means here, we are going to subtract them, then intensity becomes minimum, because the resultant amplitude of the resultant wave is nothing but this one. The resultant wave of the both waves, because they are meeting out of phase here. Then A1 minus of A2. Then the resultant amplitude is reduced. Then if the resultant amplitude is reduced, then the resultant intensity is also reduced, because intensity is directly proportional to the resultant amplitude square. Okay, this is about a destructive interference. Once again, listen here. In constructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes maximum after the superposition. But in destructive interference, the intensity of the light becomes minimum after the superposition.